Our first reading today is Luke 22, verse 41. Luke 22, verse 41. And he was withdrawn from them about a stone throw, and kneeled down and prayed, saying, Father, it is your will, take this cup from me. If it is your will, take this cup away from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. That is his prayer in the Mount of Olives. That is in the last day before his crucifixion, he prayed in the Garden of Gethsemane. And his sweat is like a blood. Father, if it is your will, take this cup away from me. Yet not my will, but yours be done. So no one took his life. He willingly gave it. He willingly gave it to do the will of the Father, a perfect act of sacrifice. The intense anguish and sorrow Jesus felt was certainly understandable. Being God, Christ knew all this was going to happen to him, but he desired to do the will of the Father. Alam po ng Panginoon what is going to happen to him, but his desire is to do the will of the Father. Sister Jasmine's illustration about giving, that David himself said he will not give anything that costs him nothing. The God himself did not give us anything that costs him nothing. He gave his son, the famous verse, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. God gave it all. He gave it all. His love for humanity drove him to the cross. The creator of the universe gave his innocent son because he loved the world too much. This is the only way he could save us, his beloved son, to be a sin offering. The Lamb of God that take away the sins of the world. You know, as a parents, people will say, how could he give his son? Is there any other that he can offer? And some people doesn't believe it. They said it's foolishness. Let's look at that first, 1 Corinthians 1:18. For the message of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. Amen. For those who are perishing, it is foolishness. Kagaguhan po yun sa mga taong na will perish. But to us who believe, it is the power of God. That is why everyone who believes in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ will be saved. Time and time again, this is Pastor Romy kept saying, and we hear it over and over again. Those people that don't believe, they have no future because they will never enter the kingdom of God. And if you don't enter heaven, you will surely perish. Now, what do you think? Why do you think people perish? Because of ignorant. Ignorant po sila. That is at Hosea 4:6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge because you have rejected knowledge. I will also reject you from being priest to me because you have forgotten the law of your God. I also forget your children. What did Hosea mean when he said, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge? The people were only ignorant of the law because they actively ignore it. Isn't it? The people are only ignorant of the law because they actively ignore it because of pride. Some people cannot take information from others because they think they are better than others. That's why they actively ignore the law. That is Hosea's warning, especially for the Israelite people. They are particularly prone with disobedience against God. The knowledge that this world needs is the knowledge of God. God clearly stated that He is not a respecter of a person. God will honor repentance. Tandaan po natin yan. God will honor repentance. I was very touched when Sister Annie publicly confessed that he ignored. He put other things before God. But she repented. And God will always honor repentance. Always. Always. When we humble ourselves before God, He will honor it. Definitely honor it. We need repentance. At Luke 24:47. That repentance and remission of sin should be preached in His name to all nations, beginning Jerusalem. Repentance po ang kailangan natin. Sin is disobedient to God's commandment. We have studied this last night. That sin is disobedient in God's commandment, either by doing what is forbidden or failing to do what is required. It is in our DNA. Disobedient po tayo. The fall of man starts when failing to do what is required. In the Bible, sin is serious evil that disrupts our relationship with God, our Heavenly Father. Although God is willing and ready to forgive us, He requires two things from us. A condition of forgiveness, as condition of forgiveness, repentance, and forgiving others. You don't expect that God will forgive you and you cannot forgive others. When you ask for forgiveness, you yourself will also need to forgive. Isn't it? We Filipino, we keep saying, well, I forgive you, but I will never forget. Let go and let God. Amen. When we ask forgiveness, we're also willing to forgive others. Because without forgiveness, without forgiving others, we will never see God. Amen. We will never see God. 2 Corinthians 5:15. And He died for all, that those who live should live no longer for themselves, but for Him who died for them and rose again. Unfortunately, some Christians live in frustration and even defeat. To them, they don't fully understand the true meaning and the message of the cross. Our sins are forgiven. Brother Romy was saying earlier that we no longer should live as a sinner. Jesus dealt a death blow in our sin to our sinful nature by giving us the power to live a life of victory each day by His Spirit, that we can really live in daily blessing and power of the things Jesus already won for us. Amen. Jesus already won in the cross. We shouldn't live as a defeated foe. We should live as victorious Christian, knowing whatever happened, He is with us. And if God is with us, no one can be against us, isn't it? We should always look at the cross. He's no longer there. He is risen. He has given us a victory to live a victorious life. That whatever we go through in life, we praise God that we are still alive. Galatians 6:14. But God forbid that I should boast except in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom the world has been crucified to me and I to the world. which should never boast but for the cross, with the cross that we are crucified from the world. You know, Paul said that to live is Christ, to die is gain. Na-crucify na tayo sa worldly thing, and we live for Christ. We live for Christ. Yes, indeed, we can reap joy, happiness, and peace now through eternity. Yan po ang purpose natin, yan po ang aim natin, to live for eternity. Yes? And all we need is the message of the cross today more than ever. Right in the midst of the massive technology that is scientific and communication breakthrough, I believe those who have true wisdom as Christian, who in simplicity saw the Spirit by glorying in the cross of the Lord Jesus Christ. What is glorying means? Glorying means you are happy to know that God had forgiven us and we can enjoy life to the full. He had given His only Son so we could have life to the full. Bakit po Kristiyano tayo, we are like defeated? We think that we are defeated. We are not defeated. We are victorious Christian. We're supposed to be a victorious Christian. Luke 15, verse 4 and 7. What a man of you having 100 sheep, if he loses one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one which is lost until he find it? And when he had found it, he lay it on his shoulder and rejoiced. Ang availability po ng forgiveness ng Panginoon. That God, that's the good news. That no matter how serious the sin is, God is always seeking us out and is willing to forgive and forget our sin and give us a fresh start. Imagine niya, yung isa lang sheep na nawala, iiwan niya yung 99 sheep to look for the one that is lost. That's the power of forgiveness ng Lord. He will leave the 99 sheep to look for the one that is lost. And you and I, if you and I are lost today, God is willing to look for you. He is willing to look for you. He will continue to knock at the door of our lives, knowing one day, we will open our hearts to Him. My beloved, as long as we are alive, it is never too late to ask forgiveness and make a new start. Yung pong power ng cross, yung pong message ng cross natin, that there is forgiveness in Christ as long as we come to Him in repentance. In repentance. Ano pong reason ng tao ay hindi nakakakilala sa Lord? Because they're stubborn. They think that some people I know, they think they have never sinned. They think that only murder is a sin. Only adultery is a sin. Every day po, nakakasala tayo. That's why we need forgiveness. That every day, God will sanctify us. That every day, God will set us apart so that we can reach eternity. Pag hindi po tayo nakarating sa langit, everything we're doing today is worthless. Nag-aaksaya po tayo ng panahon. We need to aim for greater things. And what is greater things? To be with Jesus. Yung pong aim should be the aim of every Christian. That we'll continue to walk in the narrow road. Even Jesus Himself prayed that we should not fall into temptation. Kasi po lahat ng tao are prone for temptation. Sabi nga ng Biblia, the Spirit is willing, The flesh is weak. Bakit po tayo nagkakaroon ng temptation? Sometimes po, hindi naman tayo dapat pupunta doon, pumupunta tayo. And we know we are going to be tempted. Sometimes it's the choice that will lead us in trouble. We choose to do it. And the message of the cross should be important to us. That God Himself did not give us nothing. It cost Him something. That is His only begotten Son, so that we could have a better life. Ano pong struggle ng Christian? Yes, number one enemy ng cross is money. That's why it said in the Bible, money is the root of all evil. Hindi po yun ang point eh. The love of money is the root of all evil. That's it. But when we put things right, God is able to forgive us, to give us a fresh start, knowing He can put our perspective in a right way. It's still all up to us, because the message of the cross is very clear, isn't it? The message of the cross is very clear. Sinabi po ng Romans 8, verse 1 and 2. There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus made me free from the law of sin and death. Wala na pong condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. So we will no longer live as a condemned sinner, because we are forgiven. The message of the cross is clear. He had forgiven us. He said, Father, forgive those, because they don't know what they're doing. Sometimes, when we sin, we don't know what we're doing. But sometimes there are sin that is intentionally. Diba? Alam nating mali, ginagawa natin. And you keep saying, well, nakakapagpatawad naman ang Panginoon. Never abuse the grace. We should never abuse the grace. Yes, we are no longer condemned. Yes, we are no longer a sinner. But we should never abuse the grace na binibigay ng Panginoon. We should live a holy life. Why? Because without holiness, we cannot see God. Amen. Yan pong bottom line. Without holiness, we will never see God. We will never enter heaven. And all of our suffering will be even greater if you don't enter heaven. There's hell, burning fire that you could never stand. No one can stand that fire. So our aim is to go for eternity. Sabi nga ng Panginoon Himself, I am preparing a place for you. In my Father's house, there's so many rooms. My question, is there any room for you? I hope there is, because there's so many rooms in heaven. It's mansion. If you are here looking for a house in earth, there's mansion for you in heaven. If you continue to follow God, look unto Him. He is the author and finisher of our faith. Nothing will be like Him. No one will ever be like Him. No one will ever save you and me but the cross. Only in the cross. There is a song that said, there is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. May power po ang precious blood of the Lamb.
Amen.
God did not give us anything that cost Him nothing. He gave His only Son. What a privilege we are that we can call Him Abba Father. You know, this message today is a confirmation of what Brother Romy is teaching last night. And when I come home and look at my note, Lord, this is your message today. Ipaunawa mo sa mga tao ang message ng cross. God did not give us that cost Him nothing. He gave it all so that we can have a better life. What is better life? It's not the prosperity in this earth, but knowing one day we will enter heaven. Kasi po ang material things we will all left behind. But there's only one legacy for us as a believer, that we have assurance entering heaven. Yes, lahat tayo nagkakasala. We're not perfect, but God is perfecting us for His glory. For His glory. So my advice for us as a believer, continue to seek His face. Not only His hand, but His face. The face of Christ. That He is going to make us holy. Because He is holy. Continue to have faith in Him. Because, you know, our faith is the only thing, the only strong things that will give us hope. Ang paniniwala natin na ang Panginoon ay buhay. Ang paniniwala natin na totoo ang Panginoon. We had experienced that to ourselves. In our walk with Christ, in our experience with Christ, we know that whatever happened, even in small prayer, God answered. So my advice today, if you don't have that real intimacy with Christ, continue to seek Him. Continue to seek Him. Continue to meditate in the Word of God. Continue to acknowledge Him in your life, because He said that He will never leave us nor forsake us. He will continue to guide us till the end. At sabi nga ni Romy, kung sino man po, kung tayo until the end, we need to focus till the end, that we will continue to wala pong bibitaw till the end. Yung pong bumibitaw, magiging talunan. Pero kung hindi tayo bibitaw, God will see us through. That our faith will be strong. Na kung ano mang mangyari, yeah? For better or for worse, in richer and poorer, God is with us. God is with us. And if God is with us, no one can be against us.